Welcome to Digital Communication Engineering playlist. Here in this session, I'll be explaining effect of undersampling, that is even referred as aliasing. Now, first of all, what is undersampling and how aliasing is happening? So to understand that, we need to see our previous session where I have explained sampling. Now see, in sampling rate FS that we have told, it should be greater than or equal to 2 fm. This is what we have told. So ultimately, why it should be greater than or equal to 2 fm? So to understand that, we need to see three different cases. So first, here I'll explain you first case 1, and that case is, what if fs is greater than 2 fm? Now see, as if fs is greater than 2 fm, then this is what oversampling. So we can say for this signal response, that will be somewhat this. So you'll be finding there is no overlapping of responses. So this is how response will come if fs is greater than 2 fm. Now if we consider second case, that is fs is equals to 2 fm. So in that case, this samples of frequency that will just touch to each other, so you'll be finding response will be somewhat this. Samples will just touch to each other like this, and so on. There will be continuous infinite samples. So it will be continuous up to infinite frequency. Now, if I consider third case, so for third case, this is what undersampling. What if fs is less than 2 fm? So see, here what happens, this frequency fm, now that is increasing like this. So as if frequency increases, consecutive samples will overlap to each other. So see, for this up to f omega m, if it increases up to this like this, one can see for this even, you'll be finding it increases like this. For this, it will increase like this. Similarly on negative side. So here one can see, this is where there is overlapping. This is where there is overlapping. So because of this overlapping, when you use low pass filter to extract original information, there will be distortion. The reason is, you just place over low pass filter like this and try to extract information. So there will be information of this sample as well as this sample, right? So you cannot extract proper signal. The reason is, it will be mixture of two different signals. So there will be a possibility of distortion. So this is what aliasing. So because of aliasing, overlapping is happening, and that happens in case of fs is less than 2 fm, that is even referred as undersampling. So if fs is less than 2 fm, it is undersampling. At that time, there will be overlapping of consecutive samples of frequency response, and because of that, there will be distortion when you extract signal by passing through low pass filter. So this is what the basic problem that will happen. Now see, if fs is less than 2 fm, then successive sample cycles of gf j omega will overlap each other, that we have seen already. due to aliasing effect, it is not possible to recover original signal XT by low pass filter. Here, due to overlap in one region to other region, signal XT that is distorted. So before we go for sampling, if we pass original signal through low pass filter, that is even referred as pre-aliased filter. So see, if we keep our FM, that is smaller, in that case we can provide this condition. So if FM is small, then we can have satisfaction of this condition. Like see, for example, if our FM is big, in that case there is a possibility of overlapping. The reason is this region of different samples that will increase. So if we pass our original signal X of T through low pass filter initially before we go for sampling, then we'll be restricting frequency bandwidth of original signal. So see, if we go for if we pass original signal through low pass filter, then even we can avoid this aliasing. So this is even referred as pre-aliased filter, and other name is band limited filter. So in short, to avoid aliasing, pre-aliased filter can be used, or one can keep FS greater than 2FM. So these two ways could be utilized to avoid aliasing problem. So this is how we can use sampling theorem to avoid aliasing, and that is how we should utilize that basic practice. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give me your valuable suggestions. Definitely based on your suggestions, I'll try to place videos in future which will be helpful to some other students even. So give your valuable suggestions in comment. Definitely I'll get back to you based on that. Thank you so much for watching this video.